Good morning, YouTube. Welcome to back to another Leonardo AI live stream. I'm your host, Sam Spade. So getting a little bit of a late start this morning. Only 1 minute late, better than yesterday. But so we try to make it better each day. Again, my name is Sam Spade. I'm here with another video of the Leonardo AI tool. So hopefully we get some people in the chat today and we can create some cool art together. So if you come back to the Leonardo homepage, this is what is currently trending. And I really love this app, this application, because you can create stunning artwork just like this. And if you find a picture you like, you can bring it up, check it out. You can download the image if you like it. You can switch between the, actually, we'll pop that back up. You got your original image. So this is what it originally generated. You click upscale and it re-renders the image at a higher resolution. You can see the creator that created it. You can follow this person. You can see their entire prompt details, the resolution, date it was created, guidance and step count. The seed, which I was messing around with yesterday and couldn't get it to do what I wanted, but it was interesting that the seed count is directly tied to the image that has been generated. But anyway, you can see the fine-tuned model it was created with. Let's say you find an image on Leonardo that you like. You can just come over here and hit remix. And it's going to copy over the prompt, the negative prompt, select your fine-tuned model, and change around all of the settings to correspond with that prompt, and then hit generate. So go ahead and hit generate. And for right now, I'll just show you, these were some of the ones I was messing around with yesterday. Trying to create a angelic angel person. So I actually did these off stream and I was able to spend all of my Leonardo cookies yesterday. So all 250 of them, I spent all the tokens yesterday. Didn't spend all my post-processing tokens, but let's see if that's done. Yeah, so we took the original prompt and hit remix, and we're presented with a similar image to what that person had. So this was their prompt, and it created a similar type of image. So this must be a character, Asasuku Langley. So I have noticed a lot of these prompts, they tend to get a little long, wordy, and then you've got high quality, high detail, high definition. Yeah, okay, so, and a lot of people are copying the prompts because it's like, cute face, slim waist, waist, nice hips, yada, yada, yada. 90s anime style VHS. Yeah, I just don't know. It's definitely not 90s style VHS, but we can pump up our guidance scale a little bit to more heavily weight the prompt. So we'll do that and see what that comes up with. I can't get over how it's able to create this in 30 seconds with pretty accurate details. I mean, like, you know, how the skin is being restricted by this belt, You still get some obvious defects, like she's missing a hand. Like, I don't know what's going on there, unless it's supposed to be in a pocket, but looks like she's missing a hand. So again, take that into Photoshop, whatever, whatever. So that was one thing I was messing around with yesterday. Let's say we find a image that we like let's say this one. You can click over image to image. And now we have a different prompt, but it's using this image. So it's going to try and use this prompt, but put it in a similar image like this. So it's going to try and take her, pose her kind of like this. And yeah. So the issue here is that he changed, whoever's prompt this was, changed it to 512 by 1024. So our original image is a different size, so it's actually trying to stretch it. But you can see it tried to take this person and mash it up with this image. So kind of cool. And we can change this back to what it was. So now let's try that again. So we'll hit generate. That's better. So it took that person's prompt and then tried to mash it up with our image. But as you can see, she's in almost the exact same pose. Added some angel wings. So that's in the picture. So you can see like more and more, you can just continue to add to your prompt. So let's say you really like this image here. We'll switch that one over. We're gonna have to adjust our back, stream shaper. Let's just say splash the color. Let's see what that does. So I've been kind of messing around with the image to image. And then, boom, splash of colorful paint. So we took the same image, same size, adjusted our size. So whatever prompt we used to get this, created this, we used image to image, and just said, real simple prompt, splash of colorful paint. And it just added a splash of colorful paint. That's kind of cool. Now, if you switch around to your initial strength, let's see, it says a higher strength will preserve the original image more. So let's turn it down to like 20. And it's going to switch up the image. You can kind of see, too, here it changed up her face quite a bit from the original. Yeah, so it totally took it out of our original image because we pumped it down to 20%. She's popping out of a can of paint. Interesting. I like the hair though. So we pumped it down to 20. Let's pump it up to 65. So we want to preserve that original image, but we just want a splash of paint. Nice. Not really. Just added splash paint. Let's say okay, do this. Oh, jeez. I'm blowing up, fellas. We'll be right back.